Hola, it's Dr. Bug Day, and we're going on a safari, an insect safari. Done responsibly, collecting insects is not just a great hobby, but you can learn so much about an insect's life and habitats and really understand the insect's body parts and identification clues. A specimen collection is where you will actually capture and kill insects. It's okay not to want to build a specimen collection. You can always make a photo collection or use a magnifying glass to watch them up close and personal. There are a few supplies you need to start collecting, and most can be found around the house or purchased online or at stores. You'll need a collecting net, insect pins, a collection jar, some styrofoam, and a box to store your collection. You'll want to have an identification guide, labels, and a notepad is important so you can record your findings. All right, we are ready to head out on our insect safari. With your net, you can catch by swinging it over flying insects or sweeping the net back and forth through the plants as you walk. Once you capture your insects, you'll place your insect into your collection jar or kill jar. This can be a plastic or glass jar with a lid, a bag, or an empty pill bottle works too. I like using the plastic jar best because if you visit parks, often public sites don't allow glass, for obvious reasons, of course. How do you get your insect out of your net and into the jar? Often you can just gently take your insect and place it in the jar. Or use your net like this to place your insects into the jar. Some insects do sting or bite, and always handle them carefully, especially if you're allergic to insect stings. Use your notepad to record your captures. Once you have the insects you want, you will put your collection jar into the freezer and leave it for at least 4 hours or overnight. The next step will be to pin your insects to your styrofoam. The special insect pins are thin and made from steel so they do not deteriorate. You will want to move your insect legs into a natural position. Your front legs will be placed forward, and the second and third sets of legs go a little more towards the back. Once you get them into place, it's time to pin. Most insects have generally the same body sections, the head, the thorax where the legs are, and the abdomen. Here is a picture guide of where you pin. If your insect has wings, you'll use your tweezers to gently spread the wings into place. And you can use any lightweight paper that you can place over your wing so you don't have to pin through the wing. While your collection is drying, it's the perfect time to identify your insects. In the video listed here, we chatted about the insect classifications. This is what you'll be doing, identifying and classifying your insects. Besides your ID flashcards, a very fun identification website is knowyourinsects.org. You might need some help reading, but pick your path to solve your identification mystery. So gather up your insect and tools, and let's find out just who's who. Once I ID my insect, I write that information into my notepad, and then I make a specimen label to pin right beside my insect. Once your insects have dried, you'll be ready to store your insects for display. An airtight box is best, ideally with a clear cover for viewing. Airtight is important so that other insects don't get in and eat your collection. Are you ready to start collecting? Listed below in the description is a website for an excellent free resource called How to Make an Awesome Insect Collection, available from Purdue Extension. The link to the fun identification website is also listed, and don't forget to check the library for books on insect collecting. You can become an advocate for insect conservation and help your friends and family learn about these tiny animals that are essential to our planet. Have fun on your own insect safari. Bye! Ask Dr. Bug originates from the Kids Ask Dr. Bug column, written by Dr. Tamra Reall, horticultural specialist with the University of Missouri Extension. Her column can be found in garden publications, newsletters, and Extension websites. Do you have a question for Dr. Bug? Send them to reallt@missouri.edu. Put Ask Dr. Bug in the subject and include your name and age. Or ask your questions online at the address listed here.